This LOS is describe how ratio analysis and other techniques can be used to model and forecast earnings. Model building and forecasting. So this is an important slide. You have to understand the difference between sensitivity analysis, scenario analysis, and simulation. So first of all, sensitivity analysis is also known as what-if analysis. Sensitivity analysis shows the range of possible outcomes as specific assumptions are changed. This could in turn influence financing needs or investment in fixed assets. So sensitivity analysis, what if this happened or what if that happened? And you're changing specific assumptions, okay? Scenario analysis is a little bit wider. This type of analysis shows the changes in key financial quantities that result from a given economic event, such as loss of customers, the loss of a supply source, or a catastrophic event. If the list of events is mutually exclusive and exhaustive, and the events can be assigned probabilities, the analyst can evaluate not only the range of outcomes, but also standard statistical measures, such as the mean and median value for various quantities of interest. So scenario analysis, we're looking at, what's the probability of a recession? What's the probability of not a recession? If that happens, what is our expected earnings per share? We've seen that before, the scenario analysis, when we do the binomial tree. We're looking at, what are the results given economic events, okay? And finally, simulation. This is a computer-generated sensitivity or scenario analysis. Simulation is basically scenario analysis done thousands of times. So to do so many different scenarios, we call it a simulation. It needs to be computer-generated, okay? And that also is based on a probability model for the factors that drive outcomes. Each event or possible outcome is assigned a probability. Multiple scenarios are then run using the probability of factors assigned to the possible range of values, okay? So again, a little section there on model building. What is the difference between sensitivity analysis, a scenario analysis, and a simulation? At the end of the day, what you're trying to get is some expected outcomes and sometimes some probabilities related to those possible outcomes. So because this LOS was talking about forecasting net profit margin, just going to finish the LOS with one practice question, and it's a little bit tricky. Company's taxable income is 17.1% of sales. Assuming taxes of 42% and a dividend payout of 50%, the net profit margin is closest to A, 5%, B, 7.2%, or C, 9.9%. Okay, this is a nice question. It's a little bit tricky. And again, you need to get over 70. Your target is over 70 on the each section. Sometimes you're going to get a question wrong, probably on the test. If I got this, I got over 70 in every section on level one, except for economics, I believe. And I probably would have got this wrong. But it's nice to review some of the tougher questions. Fool me once, shame on you. Fool me twice, shame on me. So I like this question. And actually, if you've done it once or twice, it's not that bad. It's kind of one of those that makes you say, aha. So we're looking for the net profit margin, or we're forecasting the net profit margin based on some data that they've given to us. So first of all, we know the net profit margin is the net income divided by sales, okay? But net income, we can also write net income as, or I put it in bold here in green, earnings before tax times 1 minus the tax rate is going to give us our net income. And we did see that before on the LOS for the DuPont, okay? I did put that in one of the slides. And this, it's just, that's a nice to know that net income is also, can be written as earnings before tax times 1 minus the tax rate. So here they've given us taxable income. That's earnings before tax. Earnings before tax, taxable income, 17.1% of sales. Aha! So I can change that earnings before tax to 0.171 times sales, okay? Then times 1 minus the tax rate, they've given us the tax rate. And this here, the dividend payout, that's just red herring information meant to confuse you. So now I can change the numerator to 0.171 times sales in brackets times 1 minus the tax rate divided by sales. What happens here is I can cross out sales from the numerator to the denominator, and I'm left with 0.171 times brackets 1 minus 0.42, 1 minus the tax rate, and I get the correct answer of C, 9.9%. 9.92, which is closest to 9.9%. So a nice little question. Those of you that are good at algebra are probably saying, yeah, that's easy, no problem. For those of you that are a little bit weaker in algebra, a nice little tricky question to end this LOS on. And that's the last slide for this LOS. Thank you.